When it comes to MVP this year, our friends at Caesars say Brady is the favorite. In fact, for the first time all year, there is an odds-on favorite, and it's Tom Brady. You see the list of those who are behind him, but right now, Brady is minus 180 to be the MVP of the league. And so I wanted to set up the conversation this way. Let's put the bars up, the pick bars up there, and let's see who everybody thinks right now. If you had a vote, who would you give your vote to for MVP? Danny Graz, I'll start with you.
Well, you convinced me. I mean, it's Brady. No, I mean, look, he's leading the league in all those categories. He hasn't missed a game, and a lot of these other guys that are contenders for this award have. And it just, you know, the whole organization feeds off of him. Like, mm-hmm. he means more than the stats show.
I think that's fair. Swagoo, who would you give your vote to?
I got Aaron Rodgers, man. I think he, the way he impacts this team, and Graz brought up a good point about missing games. I didn't have that into the equation, which could absolutely be the difference. But when you look at what this team has the ability to do when he's on the field and the one sample size we have when he didn't play for the Green Bay Packers, this team may be 500 or below if Aaron Rodgers didn't play quarterback for him. So I think his value to what they do and where they will go is all on 12.
Those are the two favorites. Jeff, who would you vote for?
Tom Brady. I ain't changed since week four. I mean, this guy has played incredible football, to Swagoo's point. Not just on his team, in the league. This guy makes, I mean, every week he's doing something that just amazes us. 44 years old and continuing to do it. Got to be Brady.
Yeah, and for what it's worth, I would give it to Rodgers, so we would be split. And I think I comfortably speak for Swagoo when I say there'd be nothing wrong with voting for Tom Brady either. That said,
Get ready.
Dominique has another contender whose name should be in the discussion. Who is that?
Micah Parsons.
Oh. Ooh. Please,
they
do tell.
Were 25th by EPA in defense last year. This year they are fifth. And I understand that we may not chalk it all up to one person, but the name of defensive football right now is versatility and flexibility. You cannot go in week to week, do what we do, because the rules will make it so that you can't compete. The fact that Micah Parsons, when you have Lawrence out, go ahead, put Parsons up there. He can do it. Randy Gregory's out? Let Parsons do it. He can do that. Oh, you need some help in the secondary? Parsons, drop him into coverage. He's going to take care of that. Oh, we need a sack fumble? He's going to do it. His ability to change this defense, tactics, no matter what they need, is what allowed them to be consistently good so far this season. His impact, and you guys said earlier that Brady's impact is not all about the statistics. Micah's stats are incredible, but his impact is not about the statistics as much as it's about the flexibility that he gives them and the resilience that he gives them defensively.
People might think sometimes you're overhyping a Cowboys player. You're not overhyping Micah Parsons and his impact. This is a player, I'll tell you, they get into training camp. He's a rookie. They get into training camp, and within a week or two, Dan Quinn, the defensive coordinator, decides and tells the team, look, this is our best player. We're going to design our defense around this guy and his strengths and give him as much responsibility as he can handle and put everything on his plate, and he has been
MVP. He's as good a pass rusher as T.J. Watt. Like, he rushes from the inside
really
and from the
rusher.
Outside, and he's an off-the-ball linebacker. His impact is outstanding.
I'm being told we're having a little bit of connectivity issue with Marcus Spears here, so you tell me, Ali, can I go to him? Because I would like a take from him on this if I can. He's good now.
You,
okay,
G.
Great. So, Swagoo, you're watching this thing snap in, snap out. Yeah. We see all the plays that he is making. And the award is called MVP for a reason. And the V stands for valuable. How would you describe how valuable, in the big picture of the Cowboys, Micah Parsons has been to this season?
Most valuable player for this football team, for sure, hands down. I mean, look, guys, go back to the Kansas City game. Micah Parsons comes up with a sack fumble and gives his team a chance to win the football game. Go back to this game this past weekend. Washington football team making moves. He goes in, sacks. Get a sack fumble that ends up in a touchdown. Not just about that. Foxy brings up great points about where he can line up as well and how effective he is. Look, it's cool to say, oh, he can line up at linebacker or he can play defensive end. It's not only that he's lining up at these positions, he's the best player when they're on the field at these positions as well. That's the difference. So when you think about him being being in the MVP conversation, obviously, I think this trophy is relegated to quarterbacks, unfortunately. Yeah. Unfortunately, I believe that it's that way. But when you start talking about most valuable player, he has to be in this conversation because this dude is actually changing games from a defensive position, which in this day and age in football is almost unbelievable, the fact that he's impacting games as much as he is.
Give me a quick take, Jeff.
Yeah, no, listen, it's Aaron Donald. I said it for years was the best player in the league. He didn't get it. He ain't getting it either,
bro. He ain't getting it, man.
It's a quarterback, and it's the
quarterback trophy, bro.
He's an absolute beast, but won't be in the conversation.
And Brady will definitely win.
The bigger point is he has transformed their entire unit. I mean, their defense was terrible last year, and now it's the reason they're winning games, and he's the biggest part of the reason. In the meantime, I agree. Brady is going to win it. And
not in my personal record book.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.